Here at ARS Fort Dietrick, we have actually three scientists who are working on the problem of boxwood blight disease. We've spent the past 10 years or so studying how this pathogen evolves and changes and moves throughout the United States, and looking to see where it came from and looking to see where it could end up next, as well as monitoring for new variants that might be even more destructive than what we have present here. My laboratory, along with many others in the United States, including other scientists here at ARS at the National Arboretum, all gathered together and developed a plan to address the issues posed by boxwood blight. And we did so in a way that would bring together specialists from many different disciplines, many different areas.
Boxwood blight is a fungal disease that began to cause the leaves to fall off of boxwoods. Boxwood has very few diseases and had very few insect pests. So to have a disease like this was a devastating blow. I was brought in to look at what was the danger to the United States from boxwood blight. It was at that time only in Connecticut and Oregon. Was it going to spread? How bad was it going to be under our climatic conditions? How bad was it going to be on our boxwood cultivars? We didn't know any of that. But shortly after I started doing research, we found there was a second species of boxwood blight that was in Europe but hadn't gotten here yet. Our lab is a lab to do risk management from invasive species, so we were also able to study the second species and see, was it a greater risk than the first? Did it behave differently from the first? And we were the only place in the U.S. that could do that research.
In our lab, we work on diagnostics for plant pathogens, and our ultimate goal is to develop a dipstick type assay, similar to what we use for COVID home tests, that could be used both in the lab and the field. It's a very simple one, just like the COVID test. In this case, instead of swabbing your nose, we just take some plant leaves that are infected and crush them up in a little bag, and then put the dipstick into the bag and get the result. We've now in hand have the reagents to develop those dipsticks, and we actually have the funding to move it forward to a commercial entity that will take our reagents and incorporate them into the little dipsticks.
We recognized pretty early on that the disease was not going to be beaten by one single bullet, one magic bullet. It was going to take many, many different approaches to effectively reduce the impact of this fungus on the United States.